Hello everyone, this is Fadi again, and in this tutorial we are going to simulate the daylight illuminance for a room. As you see, I have here a room which is a patient room in a hospital, and I made an analysis for the daylight illuminance. So we have here some windows at the south facade, and here a door, and we have a patient room. So we can easily simulate the daylight illuminance after watching this video. So let's go to Grasshopper and see how we can do that. Let's first of all turn off the simulation and go to the top. So as you see here, we have a patient room. We can turn off the furniture, and then let's see how we can do the daylight illuminance. The daylight illuminance, or the useful daylight illuminance, is an output for the Honeybee annual daylight component. So let's do that and understand how to do that. First of all, we have, as you know, to set up and construct our geometry. So from Honeybee room, from solid, we can use a prep and assign it to our geometry in Rhino, and after that we can set the parameters of the Honeybee from solid, if it is conditioned or not, or what is the program of it. So it is an hospital, and to take all the parameters of the hospitals, and then we can assign the program for it. We can also construct a window with a glass material. What's the glass material? If it is double or single. For example, here I have a double material. So I assigned a Honeybee glass material with a thickness to the window construction, Honeybee window construction. And then I put a gap with air with a thickness here in between, and then also the frame. I give some properties for the frame, for example the width, the conductance, and you can also give some properties for the outside projection, the thermal absorption, the visual absorption, the solar absorption, and so on. After that, we can easily give it to the energy plus construction for the Honeybee aperture component. So this is the aperture for the windows, and then we can also connect it to the Honeybee at the surface component, which contains the geometry, our geometry from here, the room. And then also we can have the subsurfaces that contain the windows and the construction of the windows, as we talked, and the door also. We have to assign it if there is another construction, energy blast construction or radiance modifiers. We can also give it to here. This is the basics. So in next videos we can also talk about this. Then we came to the solve the adjacents for the Honeybee model. This is if we have more than one room. So here we have a room, so it is not important for that. We can connect directly from here to the model visualization, or directly to the Honeybee model. From the Honeybee model here, you can see that we assign a grid, and we assign also after the grid, we can also have the grid from here that contains the ladybug generate point grid and the Honeybee sensory grid. We can assign a grid. For example, we have a dimension here for the grid, which is 0.5 and 0 from the surface, because I assigned a geometry for the grid, so it is not important to give a distance from the floor or so on. And then we assign all of that to to the daylight, annual daylight, honeybee annual daylight. But this component also need the WAE from ABW file, so we need a ABW file. We can easily download the ABW file from the internet, and this is the website, which is the climateonebuilding.org. You can download this EBW file, and also we have to assign the hour of the year. So this came from analysis period here. It is an output for the analysis period, so you can bring up the ladybug analysis period and then assign it to the hour of the year. And then the WEA is connected with the WEA with the annual daylight, and the model we connected here. And then we have to run the simulation. After running the simulation, we can also to see the results, we have to bring the data that is the output of the simulation, and then we have to make the average or not. It is not important, but to take all the average for the useful daylight illuminance or the useful daylight lower than useful daylight illuminance and the above the useful daylight illuminance. And this data will be connected to ladybug spatial heat map to see the results. Also here we have the ladybug legend parameter to assign, for example, colors. If you are not interested in the colors that ladybug give, which is the ladybug color range, and we will talk about it about this later. But let's run now the simulation and see the result. When we run the simulation, this window will appear to run the simulation and to see the result according to the analysis period that we have assigned, and also to the model parameters that we have assigned. So easily you can get the results of the daylight, annual daylight that contain daylight factor and other parameters such as useful daylight illuminance and the lower or the below useful daylight illuminance and the above of daylight illuminance. Let's speed up this process and see the result. So yes, we are done here. As you see, we have the result here of the useful daylight illuminance according to the analysis period that we have assigned. Maybe this is in summer period. So this is the daylight illuminance. As you see here, it is a percentage of how much is this grid have a useful daylight illuminance between 100 and 2000 lux through over the analysis period, which is from here from June to September. Yes, and the hour from 7 o'clock to 7 p.m. to 5 p.m. 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. So this is the output of the spatial heat map. So if I turn it off, it will be gone. And here, if I connect this to the data, you can see this is the below of useful daylight illuminance. This means that most of the room has 74 or 75% that are lower the useful daylight illuminance, maybe because the windows are so let's say small or something that, like that. And if I connect the useful daylight illuminance up, you can see that these are the up of the daylight illuminance, which is similarly good because it is below 1% or something like that. And here are the areas around the windows that have a much more useful daylight illuminance, which is above useful daylight illuminance. We can easily connect this one, which is the Ladybug color range, instead of these colors, so we can get some colors here, another styles of colors, for example 1, 0. When we move up, we can get more than styles of colors, but for useful daylight illuminance I prefer my colors. So if I connect these one by one, you can see that the result will be more clear for me. So this video clarify how to simulate the useful daylight illuminance by setting up a room. Maybe in next videos we can see more than the annual daylight, such as the daylight factor, and here the continuous daylight autonomy, and others, for example thermal comfort and other features such as these. Thank you for watching, and if you like this kind of videos, please like, share and subscribe for more tutorials. Goodbye.